Recruiter here. Wouldn't it be great to work for a fast-growing company that consistently promotes from within, pays above market rate, is one of the top companies to work for in the United States, and is an essential business that cannot be shut down due to COVID-19 restrictions? You guessed it, I'm talking about Wegmans, and if you happen to have an interview at Wegmans, just so happens, I know some of the questions they're going to ask you. Stick around, we'll talk about them. This video is not sponsored in any way by Wegmans. It's just a desirable place to work, and I happened to get a hold of some of their interview questions. Founded in 1916 by two brothers as a produce market, Wegmans became a force in the grocery industry in the 1950s, and since then has just grown and grown and grown. They're a family-owned company, which is not only unusual for a company of that size, but it also means that their revenue is not exactly public information. But we can surmise by their continued growth that they are definitely doing very well. Wegmans is consistently ranked in the top 5 of the Forbes Top 100 Companies to Work For list. This is no small accomplishment, and means that even low-level grocery associate positions at Wegmans are highly sought after and competitive. This is not an opportunity you want to waste. Wegmans has a large bank of questions that they could ask you on an interview, but given the nature of the business and their desire to find individuals who are highly customer-centric and who want to work in grocery and who plan to stay with the company for the long term, there are some questions that you can consistently expect to be asked on every Wegmans interview. One of the first questions you can expect to be asked, and this is common of any part-time job with a flexible, inconsistent schedule, is when can you work at Wegmans? Now, there's no set prescribed answer for this question. Obviously, your own personal schedule will dictate, but what they're looking for is that you are dedicated, you are flexible, you are willing to work not the greatest hours like opening time and closing time. You're willing to work weekends and you're willing to work holidays. Remember, Wegmans is looking for customer-centric employees who want to work in the grocery industry and are committed to being there for the long term. So you definitely want to bend over backwards to be as flexible as you can. Just don't overcommit to a time schedule that you won't actually be able to maintain due to school or other work. A second question that you are highly likely to be asked on any Wegmans interview is, what can you tell me about Wegmans, or what do you know about Wegmans? And here it is critically important to have done the research. I strongly recommend spending a considerable amount of time on their careers website studying the history of the company and the About Us section of the company. Know who the current CEO is. Hint, it's Colleen Wegman. Know the company's history from their founding in 1916 through some of their expansion. Know how many stores they have open currently. Know that Wegmans are typically considered superstores, as in they're larger than the regular grocery store. They typically have a to-go section, a grocery store, liquor store, and wine shop. Know that they cater to the high-end market, that they focus on Northeast and Mid-Atlantic states. Definitely know that they're a family-owned and operated business. Definitely know that they're well-known for their Green Leaf and Italian Classics line. And make sure you check any news or press releases for the latest public information available about them. It is a near certainty that you will be asked the question, why do you want to work for Wegmans? And it is critically important that you plan and prepare your answer for this question. Don't try to wing it, they're likely to pick you apart for that. When you're thinking about framing your answer to this question, just think to yourself, what's great about Wegmans? Why is it special? Why do people want to work there? Think about you personally. Why do you want to work in grocery? And what's your experience dealing with customers? How do you like interacting with customers? Do you get a buzz from providing somebody a great service? Talk to them about how you expect to enjoy working in grocery and you expect to enjoy working with people. And most importantly, be positive and enthusiastic about the brand. It is absolutely critical that you show enthusiasm about the brand and about the fact that you're interviewing for a job there. That enthusiasm lets them know that you're serious, that you're interested, and frankly, it's infectious. And on job interviews, showing enthusiasm is definitely an important thing to do. There are some things you're going to want to avoid when it comes to how you answer this question of why you want to work for Wegmans. avoid proximity to the job. Saying that Wegmans is right around the corner from you where you live is not a compelling reason why you want to work there. Steer clear of any implication that you need this job because you need money now. Steer clear of any indication that you're just doing this job until something better comes along. And generally speaking, anything that Wegmans wouldn't care about, anything that's not important to Wegmans, keep it focused on the job itself, the customers, and the experience, and you will do fine. Wegmans will definitely want to ask you about your previous employment history, and this is where you actually have a real opportunity to shine. Even if you're a student and you don't actually have any previous work history, you can still tie things that you've done in your academic life, such as athletics, student government, any clubs or associations that you belong to, into this job interview and relate how those experiences have helped prepare you for dealing with customers at Wegmans. Think about how you can tie those experiences together with what's important to Wegmans. For those who do have previous work history, as far as how you answer this question, make sure that you provide good reasons for leaving, that if you were terminated from any jobs, you don't bring that up right on the first interview. In fact, it would be best not to bring that up at all. How the experience that you had at that employer is related to the experience that you'll need to be successful at Wegmans. And if they're positive, you want to provide references. Be very careful with this. Make sure that anybody you provide as a reference knows that you're doing it and will answer positively. Another question that you can be certain you'll be asked at an interview at Wegmans is, how would you manage a complaint from an angry customer? Now, this is a behavioral interview question, but it's more of a hypothetical than it is looking for a previous experience. If you've had previous experiences in customer service dealing with angry customers, you will want to provide a specific example. The important things that Wegmans is looking for in this answer are, number one, de-escalation techniques. They want to understand that you can empathize with a customer and bring the volume down on a situation, even when the customer is angry and having a bad experience. And two, that you are able to clearly communicate to the customer that you're 100% committed to finding a resolution to their problem without giving a bunch of shit away for free or going outside of Wegmans policy. They want to know that you clearly understand there is a line, and that line is Wegmans policy, and you will do everything in your power within that policy to turn it into a positive experience for the customer. This is what they are looking for. De-escalation, empathy, 100% committed to solving the problem within Wegmans policy. Much like any other job interview out there, when you get to the conclusion of the interview at Wegmans, the store manager or whoever's interviewing you is highly likely to ask you, do you have any questions for me? If you say no, you are basically saying, I have absolutely no interest in this job whatsoever, and I'd like the interview to end now, so I'm just gonna say no questions and we're gonna shake hands and part ways. You must ask questions at the end of any job interview, particularly one at Wegmans. A few good questions that you can definitely ask would be, number one, what are the next steps in this process? That shows that you're interested in continuing the conversation. Number two, what should a new hire do to prepare for their first day at Wegmans? This is a great question to ask because not only does it put the hiring manager in the mind frame that you already work there, but number two, it shows such initiative to want to find out what you can do to prep for day one. This is a great question to ask and I highly recommend it. Another great question to ask is, what is the culture at the store and on the team that you'd be working for? Cultural fit is very important to Wegmans. They're still a family-owned company. They strive to create a certain type of culture. It's a great culture, and they're gonna wanna know that you wanna be a part of that. Another super question that you can ask a store manager or whoever's interviewing you is, how would you describe the ideal Wegmans employee? Now, when they paint that picture for you of what the ideal employee looks like, you should be thinking about your experiences, be they previous work experiences or academic experiences, and how your experience paints that same picture. You are the ideal Wegmans employee. Throughout the course of the interview, you and the hiring managers will talk about things, and some of those things should create more questions for you. I recommend that you create one, or even better, two questions on the fly Based on the conversation that you had during the interview, this is going to show that you were engaged, that you were listening, and that you're thinking about what they've had to say. So if you can pull all that together, you have a really great shot of landing a really great job at a top 5 best company to work for in the United States, who promotes from within, and who people go to work for and stay there for 20, 30, 40 years because it's a great company with a great culture. Now, do this. Watch either of the 2 videos on the screen right now. They are gonna help you enormously as you pursue that job of your dreams and look to make the most of your career. Thanks for watching. Bye for now. I'll see you next time. Peace.